There's a lot going on in the hobby, and we cover it all in our weekly Hobby Happening segment. So here's a look at this week's news, notes, and nuggets from the world of sports cards and memorabilia from around the interwebs. Well, what did LeBron James think when he found out that his rookie card sold for $1.8 million? Well, let's watch and find out.
One of your rookie basketball cards bid for $1.8 million and another bid for $900,000. I mean, given your kind of humble beginnings, I mean, what do you think of that when, I mean, you're still playing and it's not like you're Honus Wagner or Babe Ruth or something. I mean, how do you kind of take that in when somebody's paying $1.8 million for your rookie card?
I think it's pretty cool. That's the first thing I think about and think about where I come from. You know, hearing those numbers, you didn't hear those numbers much growing up, you know, obviously where I'm from. And the second thing I think about is I have two rookie cards of my own. So I'll be good for a very, very long time. No matter what happens, I'm good.
The official retail shop for Major League Baseball opened in New York City last week. And check this out, an entire section dedicated to Topps baseball cards. Very cool. And if you're like me and skeptical of gift shops and their pricing, you'll be very excited to hear that it seems that all the pricing is at retail MSRP, and there is a limit of one item per type per person. So you could go and get five or six different boxes, but nobody's there able to just clear out the shelves. So check it out if you're in the New York City area.
Nice. Well, a pair of rookie year game-worn Air Jordans sold at Heritage Auctions this past weekend for the impressive sum of $117,000. What's even more impressive is the manner in which one enterprising young fan acquired them. I'm going to point you in the direction of Sports Collectors Daily to find out for yourself the full story.
Really cool. PSA announced this week that they have launched a customer communication center, saying that the center pulls back the curtain for PSA customers, spotlights industry trends, PSA growth, capacity improvements, upcoming initiatives, recent updates, and a whole lot of data. Check out PSA's new customer communication center at www.psacard.com/communication.
Cool. Well, unless you've spent the last year living in a cave, and for many it may have seemed like that, then you know the sports card market is currently in its new golden era, returning once again to its status as a billion-dollar industry. As an example, eBay recently reported some absolutely staggering year-over-year sales records in its collectibles category for the month of September. And yes, leading the way is soccer cards, with an increase in sales of 982%, followed by, surprisingly maybe, tennis at 535 and golf at 320, before the big four weighs in with football cards with 240% increase.
Very impressive. In what has to be one of the best click-enticing headlines in the hobby, Sports Collectors Daily reports on an article titled "Money Laundering, Murder, and a Museum." What became of the PSA 10 George Mikan rookie card?
I want to know.
Apparently, internet sportsbook Five Dimes has agreed to forfeit more than $46.8 million as part of a settlement in a federal money laundering investigation, according to a news release from U.S. Attorney's Office for the Eastern District of Pennsylvania. The settlement includes the forfeiture of the lone PSA 10 rated 1948 Bowman rookie card of NBA legend George Mikan. Read the full story on Sports Collectors Daily. It's a page burner.
It is a page burner. It's the son of the guy who owns the Giant Eagle grocery chain, who died, murdered. It's bizarre. Check it out. Sorry. In other news from SCD, it appears that the Baseball Hall of Fame Shoebox Treasures exhibit has some new additions, including a Mike Trout 2009 Bowman Chrome Red Refractor and rookie cards of 14 baseball legends, including Hank Aaron, Roberto Clemente, Roy Campanella, and Ernie Banks, to name a few. Admission to the Shoebox exhibit is included with your trip to the Baseball Hall of Fame. So if you're heading that direction, don't miss it.
Now for some updates on some of the hot auctions we've talked about in recent weeks. First up is that autographed section of the Staples Center floor on which Kobe Bryant scored 60 points in his final NBA game. That item sold for $631,200 in Heritage Auctions recent Michael Jordan and Basketball Icons catalog sale.
In the same auction, the 2004 Topps Chrome LeBron James 101 Superfractor graded in a PSA 10 soared to $720,000 after a flurry of last-minute bidding. Incredible given the fact that the pre-sale estimate was just over $200,000, but that's what can happen when two people want something bad enough.
This resolution photo-matched game-used home uniform from Jordan's 1986-87 season sold for $480,000. It's crazy. Three in a row, and we're only down to $480,000. While an all PSA 10 set of 1986-87 Fleer basketball cards without the sticker set sold for $216,000.
And that's interesting to note, too, because the last set had the stickers and sold for $200,000. Two boxes, sealed boxes of 86-87 Fleer basketball from a previous find we had talked about. Actually, one's sealed by Baseball Card Exchange and one's not. Sold for $96,000 and $75,000, respectively. Sports Collectors Daily reports that in total, the auction realized over $4.26 million with more than 6,400 bids placed during the event, many of which came after the auction went into extended bidding late Saturday night.
We mentioned a minute ago about eBay seeing a large increase in the golf product category. Well, based on this interview that Upper Deck's Chris Carlin had with ABC7 Detroit's Brad Golly, it appears that golf will be making a comeback to the company's new product portfolio. Watch this.
The golf license, I don't know if you guys still have it. The stuff that you made in the past was just so incredible. And I'm curious if you have any plans in the near future to dive back into that with some cards.
Yeah, I mean, Tiger Woods is a longtime spokesperson for Upper Deck. We made his rookie card way back in 2001. And so Tiger's been a part of our product trading card releases throughout the course of our history, having him under a deal. But nowadays it's in products like Goodwin Champions that feature a variety of different athletes and personalities. But I can say that we feel like the golf trading card category isn't an every year type of category. It's hard to develop new rookies each year. We've tried it. It hasn't always done what we hoped. I would say that if you are a fan of golf and are looking for collectibles, going back through the Upper Deck products, trading card releases that are out there is a lot of fun. There's still an okay supply of them. That is going to dry up. And I think that's going to happen when we produce our next golf releases. So I can't say that we actually have several in the works right now, but we're not at the point where we can disclose what they are, when they'll release, but it's happening.
So I did hear you correctly. You do have some in the works, just no target dates yet. Is that fair?
Correct. That's fair to say.
Very cool. I just left Detroit Golf Club for a story where the Rocket Mortgage Classic happens. And I know that's something that there were a lot of young people out there last year when there were fans allowed. And I just thought, I'm like, man, wouldn't that be something cool to have, I mean, with this young generation of golfers, young generation of fans now picking up some cards. So that is exciting.
I'm hopeful, actually, that we're going to be able to release some information on that in the next month. So I won't have to wait too much longer to hear, but But my lips are supposed to be sealed, but see, I share.
You might remember that a couple of months ago we told you about the 600 1995 action-packed autographed cards found in a storage unit in Las Vegas. Now Sports Collectors Daily is reporting that 85 of those cards were sold to none other than the Gold and Silver Pawn Shop of Pawn Stars fame. Well, this past Tuesday, at the idea of Chumley, those cards were featured in a live streaming break with spots going for $99 and included four of the Bill Russell cards, which were authenticated and encapsulated by Beckett. The story of the find, sale, and highlights of the break will be featured in an upcoming episode. Sweet.
Almost 100,000 card collectors across more than 400 hobby shops nationwide participated in the 2020 Panini NBA Player of the Day Hobby Shop promotion this season. So that tells you your odds. And although tens of thousands of prizes were awarded to collectors, pretty good odds, only one, 18-year-old Heather May of North Wilkesboro, North Carolina, parlayed her lucky pack of Panini NBA trading cards into the grand prize. This past Saturday, May, who is a huge Duke University basketball fan, was surprised with the news at a special event at her favorite card shop, and GTS customer Score More Sports Collectibles in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, with video messages from two of her favorite former Blue Devils players, Seth Curry and, hold the hate, Christian Laettner. Following the announcement, May received a Panini America swag bag featuring apparel, cards, and more, including autographed items from some other notables, Jason Tatum and Quinn Cook, in addition to Laettner. Check out some of the highlights of May's special day here.
Hey, Heather.
Seth Curry here.
Christian Laettner here. I've heard you are a big Duke fan.
I have some great news for you. You're the winner of the Panini NBA Player of the Day National Sweepstakes.
What?
During these challenging times, Panini is working hard to put together a special experience for you.
You'll be receiving cards, autographs, swag, and a personal meeting with an NBA player. It's not me, but it will be a fellow Dukie.
Until then, please enjoy these goodies from my friends at Panini.
We planned on coming today, but I did not know that this was going to happen, like, at all. And then I walked in, and there was all these people, and then the video started playing, and it was like, oh my gosh, like, I can't believe it. I can't believe I won. There was 100,000 contestants, and Panini's giving me, like, all these cards and gifts and worth, like, $2,500. My grandfather was a huge Duke fan, and he always had me wearing Duke clothes, and he always told me that Duke was the best. I've just lived by that my whole life. I kind of made it a little mission to get as many Duke autographs that I can, and I didn't have Jason Tatum yet. They gave me that autographed picture, and that was really special. Right now, I'm a basic EMT, but I'm in paramedic school. Collecting cards is pretty much my only hobby. I don't do anything else, really. I want to stay focused on school and family, and collecting cards is just something we do, and I hope to pass along that my cards and like the love of cards to my kids.
On behalf of Panini and all of us at Score More Sports, congratulations, Heather.
Very cool. Congratulations, May. So you want to buy a complete 2020 Topps baseball card factory set. All right. Well, there's no less than six different versions this year, and they're really different from each other. Although two are pretty exclusive. I mean, one being this first edition set sold through Rally, and then the one available to 582 Montgomery Club members, also exclusive. Well, there's a hobby version, a regular retail version, and exclusive versions to both Walmart and Target. So what are the differences unique to each one, you ask? Well, Ryan Cracknell, one of the hardest working men in trading cards at Beckett Media, sorted all that out for you in a handy guide. And I'm not about to steal his thunder, so check it out on Beckett.com.
Yeah, read it twice because there's a lot. Collector's Universe, parent company of PSA, announced that they will be expanding their existing headquarters and operations facility, doubling its space to 125,625
square feet. To a new space. Holy cow.
Well, as the company pushes forward with plans to add automation to its grading and authentication procedures, and it's worth noting, Collectors Universe, the parent company, does coins, comic books. There's a number of other things that they're also authenticating. So it makes sense. But yes, they just did that. Wow. Joe Orlando, President and Chief Executive Officer of Collectors Universe, said, "This new space not only gives our team the ability to grow our core authentication and grading operations, but also ample room to integrate technology solutions and support our long-term vision for the company."
Cool. Sports Collectors Daily reports there's a new highest-priced vintage baseball card of all time. Mile High Card Company says that a new copy of the Honus Wagner, this one in a PSA 3, sold for $3.25 million in a private transaction facilitated by the Mile High Card Company. That price eclipses the $3.12 million price tag for the one, the PSA 5 miscut, also known as the Jumbo Wagner, which sold in 2016. And that's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings.